So good morning. Let us look at the spotters which are there in your exam, university exam. Usually biochemistry spotters carry 20 marks. I mean 10 spotters each carry 2 marks. So 2 into 10 spotters, 20 marks. As per last year's schedule, it was same. Hope there is no changes. So total there are 15 spotters. So you have to remember, you have to either identify the reagent and you have to tell the use, or identify the lab apparatus or lab instrument. Okay. So some of them things you know, it is simple, but you have to remember by seeing the diagram. Okay. So usually this will be as a demo experiment. Just it is displayed during exam on the screen, so you will be given easily 1 minute. Within 1 minute you have to write the answer. Okay, so mention the use of this reagent. This is the reagent. Okay, this is the reagent. Mention the use of this reagent. You have to write only use. Okay, nothing else. So what it is written there, Benedict's reagent. I think I have told to one batch, Benedict's reagent, which is blue in color. So it is used to detect the presence of reducing sugars. You have studied the chemistry of carbohydrate. I told you sucrose is non-reducing, and all glucose, fructose, monosaccharides, lactose, maltose, okay, galactose, all reducing sugars. So presence of any reducing sugar, in the presence of any reducing sugar, we get Benedict's positive result in the presence of any reducing sugars. This is used to detect the presence of reducing sugars. More approximately, exact is in urine, to detect the presence of reducing sugars in urine. So what is the use of this spotter one? Mention the use of this reagent is to detect the presence of reducing sugars. Okay, so this is the one of the semi-quantitative or qualitative test. We have to add 5 ml of Benedict's reagent, which is blue in color, then add 8 drops or 0.5 ml of urine, boil, mix and boil for 2 minutes. If reducing sugars are there in the urine, means Benedict's reagent color changes from light green to dark green, yellow, orange, and finally brick red. Brick red means it is almost precipitates, so it is 4+. So depend on that, color changes. So spotter number one, mention the use of this reagent to detect the presence of reducing sugar. Let us see spotter two, mention the use of this reagent. So this is used for phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride. This is phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride. This is used to detect the presence of reducing sugar. Again, this is used to detect the presence of reducing sugar. So what is the answer? Mention the use of this reagent to detect the presence of reducing sugars by ozazone test. Okay, by ozazone test. Okay, there are many tests to detect monosaccharides, carbohydrate monosaccharide. First we will see general test, Mollis test we will do, and then we will go for Benedict's test, whether it is reducing sugar or not. then we will go for whether it is monosaccharide or reducing disaccharide. Okay, then we will check whether it is aldose or ketose by Selvinoff's test. Then there is one more test to detect difference, that is to detect whether it is maltose or lactose, detection of maltose and lactose, especially this ozazone test. Okay, so this is answered by only reducing sugars. Reducing sugars answer this ozazone test. Okay, reducing sugars answers ozazone test. How this test is performed is, so we have to boil the sugar solution with phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride, okay, with the buffer solution we have to prepare, and we have to add sugar solution and boil with phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride buffer solution. After 30 minutes you have to wait until it cool, so there is a formation of crystals. These crystals are ozazones, so sugars form their respective ozazones, either fructose zone or glucose zone or maltose zone or lactose zone, etc. Okay, that is the test is called ozazone test. So this reagent phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride is used to detect the presence of reducing sugars by ozazone test. Okay, so mention the use of this reagent to detect the presence of reducing sugars by ozazone test. So this test is for ozazone test is performed only for reducing sugar. Okay, spotted third, mention the use of this reagent. This is Selvinoff's reagent. Okay, this is Selvinoff's reagent, Selvanoff's. Selvanoff's. Selvinoff's reagent. See, this test is to identify carbohydrates, especially to distinguish between aldose and ketose sugar. So this test is answered by only keto sugars. Okay, this is one of the tests to detect aldose sugar and keto sugar. So what is the answer? Mention the use of this reagent to distinguish between aldose and keto sugar. Test is answered by only keto sugar. If sugar is keto sugar, then a Selvinoff gives positive. Positive means in the presence of keto sugar we get cherry red color. That means Selvinoff's positive. Cherry red is like what we keep in the ice cream head, you know, the cherry fruit, same color, cherry red color. Okay, pinkish red, cherry red color we will get if Selvinoff's positive. So what is the use of this reagent? Answer is to distinguish between aldose and ketose sugar. So test is answered by only ketose sugar. Okay, I will just explain you. Aldose sugar, which one? Glucose. Keto sugar, fructose. So if you know that it is a carbohydrate, but you have to distinguish which monosaccharide, aldose or ketose, you can use this Selvinoff's test. So if you boil sugar, glucose with the Selvinoff's reagent, exact 30 seconds, so there is no change in the color. Either it is very light pink or no change in the color, but you have to boil exact 30 minutes. But if you boil fructose solution or even sucrose, because sucrose contains fructose, if you boil Selvinoff's reagent, if you boil fructose solution added to Selvinoff's, okay, then you get cherry red color, okay, within 30 seconds. So fructose is keto sugar, so it gives Selvinoff's test positive. So whatever, now answer for this question is, mention the use of this reagent. What is the answer? To distinguish between aldose and keto sugar, test is answered by only ketose sugar. Spotter 4, the use of this reagent. Mention the use of this reagent. The use of this reagent means mention the use of this reagent. What is that reagent labeled alpha naphthol? So answer is, it is used in Mollisch test to detect carbohydrate. What is the spelling? Mollisch, M-O-L-I-S-C-H. Mollisch test to detect carbohydrate. Okay, Mollisch test to detect carbohydrate. Okay, so the use of, mention the use of this reagent. Reagent, what is the reagent? Alpha naphthol. So what is the answer for this spotter? It is used in Mollisch test to detect carbohydrate. So I will explain this. There is one general test for carbohydrate. Any carbohydrate solution, whether it is starch or sucrose or glucose or fructose, any carbohydrate gives Mollisch test positive. Positive means we will get reddish violet ring at the junction of two layer. What you have to do actually, you have to take 2 ml of carbohydrate solution. What is the meaning? Whether glucose, fructose, lactose, whatever, you have to take 2 ml of carbohydrate in a test tube solution in a test tube, sugar solution in a test tube, add 2 drops of alpha naphthol. Okay, then mix, and you have to add slowly 2 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid along the side of the test tube. Okay, slowly you have to add, in incline or slant position, slowly you have to add from the side of the test tube. Which one? Sulfuric acid you have to add. First you have to take carbohydrate solution 2 ml, add 2 drops of alpha naphthol, same this reagent, then mix, then slowly add concentrated sulfuric acid without shaking or disturbing the test tube. That is very important, so that a reddish violet ring forms at the junction of two layers if the solution contains carbohydrate. So Mollisch test is general test for carbohydrate. So spotter number 4, the use of this reagent. What is the answer? It is used in Mollisch test to detect carbohydrate. Next spotter, identify the ozone crystals. I told you before, phenyl hydrazine hydrochloride, that reagent used for ozone test to distinguish aldose sugar or keto sugar. Keto sugar gives ozone positive. So this you have to observe under the microscope. Ozone test you have to observe under microscope. This is the reagent. Which one? This is the reagent used for ozone test. We are reducing sugar with the ozone. Wait for 30 minutes, then crystals forms, that you have to observe under microscope. This is the crystal actually. What we found, this is the, 1 minute, this is the crystal. So what is the question? Identify the ozone crystal. So answer is, this is, you see, can see that these are needle shaped crystals. This you have to see under low power, okay, under the microscope. Ozone test result you have to observe under the microscope. You have to put the crystal in a slide and observe under low power microscope. So if it is the crystal of glucose or fructose, glucose and fructose produce the same type of crystal, that is needle shaped crystals of glucose or fructose. Glucose zone and fructose zone, same shape. So what is the answer? Needle, this is needle shaped crystals of glucose or fructose. Is it clear? needle shaped crystals of glucose or fructose. Okay, needle shaped crystals of glucose or fructose, because glucose or and fructose give same type of crystal. And one more information, maltose gives sunflower petal shaped crystal, and lactose gives spine shape or hedgehog, one animal is there, no, small one, that all ball type, spine type crystal of lactose zone, lactose. Maltose gives sunflower petal shaped crystals, but glucose and fructose gives needle shaped crystals. So answer is needle shaped crystals of glucose or fructose. Spotter number 6 is identify the molecule. I don't want to waste much time here. This is the glucose molecule. What is the formula? C6H12O6. Okay, so this can be written, glucose is written as open chain, okay, or closed chain, C6H12O6. So this is glucose molecule. Spotter 7, identify the lab apparatus. This is a glass apparatus. You can see there it is a flask, but pear shape, pear fruit, you know, pear shape, not exactly round, but pear shape, flat bottom is there, okay, and rubber cork, glass cork also there, cork is there, and it is mentioned, one marking is there, you can see there. So it is either this is mentioned 500 ml, sometimes 100 ml, 50 ml also comes. So this is a standard flask. It is not just a flask, actually it is glass one, whatever it is, a answer is standard flask. It is accurate, okay, up to the mark. Below A, one mark is there, no, in the neck, up to the mark it is 500 ml. So identify the lab apparatus, your answer is standard flask. Next is 8th one, identify the lab apparatus. This is actually glass pipette, PIPETTE, pipette. You have seen in the lab, it seems. Nowadays automated pipettes also there to transfer the reagent in micro mls, in mls, like 1 ml, 2 ml, 0.5 ml, and all. We can use this glass pipettes. They are accurate, actually they are calibrated at certain point, they are accurate. So answer is glass pipette. 9th one is identify the lab apparatus. This is conical flask, you can see it is cone shaped, conical shaped, some reagent is put and is graduated also. Usually this is used for titration and all, okay, acid base titration. So your answer is conical flask. 10th one is, you know that this is the burette, okay, used acid base titration, this is burette. 11th one, identify the lab apparatus. This is funnel, this is actually glass funnel, plastic items also coming, glass funnel. This is mainly used for separation, for the separation, okay, or filtration, what we call filtration, okay. So filter, usually we put Wattman number 1 paper above that cone shaped top, and we add the precipitate solution. So supernatant will and down we will keep a test tube. Precipitate or residue remain on the filter paper above the cone, and down we can collect supernatant clear fluid. So filtration this is used. So what is the answer here? Glass funnel. Just answer is glass funnel. 12th one, this is beaker, usually used for the preparation of reagent. Lab, you can see different shaped beaker. We can see there one spout is there, that one edge is there, no, that is called spout, to transfer the reagent or heating purpose and all. So this is beaker. This is like test tube to perform different test. This is a little harder, stronger one, centrifuge tube. We can keep in the centrifuge machine. I will show the machine at the end. This is centrifuge tube. You can see at the one end is open, other end is closed, but it is narrow, conical shaped. Usually it is graduated. Okay, this is used for centrifugation, separation of solid from liquid. Either a blood component we can centrifuge, or any other material. If you want to separate solid from liquid in a solution, we can put in the centrifuge machine. It rotates resolution per minute and get separated. So sediment, what we call solid, that remains at the bottom. Okay, see, narrow shaped bottom. So this tube is identified by the lab apparatus. Your answer is centrifuge tube. Next, last but one, this is a measuring cylinder. Okay, measuring cylinder. Okay, this is measuring cylinder. This is, you can see in the lab, generally it is comes under 500 ml, 1 liter, 100 ml, 5 liters also used for the preparation of reagent. Here also markings are there, but it is not so accurate as your standard flask or glass pipette. So this is the answer is measuring cylinder. Okay, last 15th one is identify the lab instrument. This is centrifuge tube. You have centrifuge machine. See, this tube is used as a centrifuge tube, either glass or plastic. So this is the, what is this machine? You can see in the inside with the blue cap, what they kept is in opposite side balance is there. So it rotates when you switch on the light and turn on button, it rotates resolution per minute. Usually lab 1000 to 3000 rpm revolution per minute is used. So this answer is for this 15th is centrifuge machine. These are all the main spotters.